Good evening, friends. On behalf of Stephen and Floor and their families, and in the good name of Jesus Christ, I welcome you to this place made sacred by our love, our faith, and our great joy. My name is Chris Hayden. I'm pastor of Trinity Covenant Church in Lexington, Massachusetts, and Stephen's pastor. I'll be sharing the officiating of the service tonight with Pastor Nestor Herente, and we're very glad to have the pastor with us. Dear friends, we've gathered here in the presence of God to unite this man and this woman in holy marriage, which is instituted by God, regulated by his commandments, blessed by our Lord Jesus Christ, and to be held in honor among all people. Let us therefore remember that God has established and sanctified marriage for the welfare and happiness of his human family. For that reason, our Savior has declared that a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one. By his apostles, he has instructed those who enter into such a relationship to cherish a mutual esteem and love, to share in each other's infirmities and weaknesses, to provide for each other and for their households, and to live together as heirs of the grace of life. Will you bow with me in prayer? O holy God, our hearts are overflowing with joy for the miracle you have created this night, for gathering together the lives, the loves, the hearts of Stephen and Floor, granting them the gift of each other's presence for their life together forever. We thank you for the happy miracle that you have created and for inviting each of us by your Spirit to gather here and to be bonded to Floor and to Steve for their life together. We thank you for your love for all of us, and we ask for each of us a new beginning in your love this night, in all our relationships, in our love for you, and in our work for you in your world. In Jesus' name, amen. Please be seated. We're now going to share two scripture readings, and Elise and Alyssa will read for us.
A reading from John 15. I am the true vine, and my Father is the gardener. He cuts off every branch in me that bears no fruit, while every branch that does bear fruit, he prunes, so that it will be even more fruitful. You are already clean because of the word I have spoken to you. Remain in me as I remain in you. No branch can bear fruit by itself. It must remain in the vine. Neither can you bear fruit unless you remain in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. If you remain in me and I in you, you will bear much fruit. Apart from me, you can do nothing. This is to my Father's glory, that you bear much fruit, showing yourselves to be my disciples. As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Now remain in my love. If you keep my commands, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commands and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete. My command is this: love each other as I have loved you. Greater love has no one than this, to lay down one's life for one's friend. You are my friend if you do what I command. I no longer call you servants, because a servant does not know his master's business. Instead, I called you friends, for everything that I've learned from my Father, I have made known to you. You did not choose me, but I have chosen you, and I have appointed you so that you might go and bear fruit, fruit that will last, and so that whatever you ask in my name, my Father will give you. This is my command: love each other.
First Corinthians chapter 13. If I speak with human eloquence and angelic ecstasy, but don't love, I am nothing. If I speak God's word with power, revealing all his mysteries and making everything plain as day, and if I have faith that says to a mountain, jump, and it jumps, but I don't love, I am nothing. If I give everything I own to the poor, and even go to the stake to be burned as a martyr, but I don't love, I've gotten nowhere. So no matter what I say, what I believe, and what I do, I am bankrupt without love. Love never gives up. Love cares more for others than for self. Love doesn't want what it doesn't have. Love doesn't strut, doesn't have a swelled head, doesn't force itself on others, isn't always me first, doesn't fly off the handle, doesn't keep score of the sins of others, doesn't revel when others grovel, takes pleasure in the flowering of truth, puts up with anything, trusts God always, always looks for the best, never looks back, but keeps going to the end. Love never dies. Inspired speech will be over someday. Praying in tongues will end. Understanding will reach its limit. We know only a portion of the truth, and what we say about God is always incomplete. But when the complete arrives, our incompletes will be canceled. When I was an infant at my mother's breast, I gurgled and cooed like an infant. When I grew up, I left those infant ways for good. But it won't be long before the weather clears and the sun shines bright. We'll see it all then, see it as clearly as God sees us, knowing him directly just as he knows us. But for right now, until that completeness, we have three things to do to lead us towards that consummation. Trust steadily in God, hope unswervingly, love extravagantly. And the best of these three is love.
Steve and Floor, turn around for a minute. Just turn around. These are many of the people who love you all the way around. Look at them. Your family and your friends and your church family. The people who have made their love so much a part of your lives. We've come to be with you, for in your being together, you've made your love a part of our lives. And we've come to say thank you for sharing that love with us. We've come to bless you in your new life together, and we've come to witness a miracle. Not that you're in love, because anyone who's seen you knows that that's very obvious, but that your love is of God and is therefore more powerful and life-giving than you or we can imagine. You can turn back around now. Sometimes even miracles of love aren't enough. We need miracles of new life, of new beginnings, for someone to come and find us, for someone to rescue us, someone to help us, someone to heal and to change us, someone to stand beside us and love us enough till we can begin to believe that our own miracles are true. Stephen, you are that miracle to us. Like Lazarus in John 11, many of us thought we had lost this boy we love. You wandered off in the dark, but God never lost sight of you. You know now that it was God's grace bringing you through every step, building inside your heart the strength to believe, to endure, and to trust, and to be patient. And he gave you the love of family and friends that kept believing in you even when you didn't have the spirit to believe yourself and to believe in yourself. And in the truth that God loves you with an everlasting love and will never let you go, that he has a marvelous future prepared for you. And so God gave you Floor, and Floor, God gave you Stephen, to open the eyes of your hearts, to hope again, to love again, to live again, to believe again, and begin to see the future that he wants for both of you. I even wore my Easter stole because you are a resurrection for us. And like Jesus calling his friend out of the tomb, Christ has called you, our friends, into this new life. He's calling you, Stephen, to untie and to shake off those old dead clothes and to learn to wear new clothes, like faith and hope and love and another gift, another miracle, to wear a wedding suit for this best friend whom you found. Floor and Steve, there may be regrets about the past, but I don't want you to regret them. Continue to learn from them as you have from all the times that you learned to love and to trust and to endure, and to hope and believe and keep on going when you could have given up. For God has been using all these experiences in your lives to draw you together, to prepare you for each other. For what attracted you to each other is the very things I see that you share, hearts that are kind and good, caring and forgiving, full of laughter and hope, eager to give and to serve. Loyal as friends and loving to other people. But more than this, God opened the eyes of your hearts to see each other out of every other out there. And you said, there you are. There's my best friend. There you are. There's the part of my heart I've been looking for all my life. As you chose each other as best friends, you're eager to do what so many of us have forgotten to do, to be friends, to be lovers, to be servants, to be children, and so to be children of God. In loving each other, you found the heart of it. And that makes you a miracle that we all need to see again to believe the miracle about ourselves, that God could possibly love us as much as he is loving you right now. We need to know that such a new life is possible for us too. When Jesus knew that he had to leave his friends to live his life and love his people without him, he shared this word we heard from John 15. Stay close to God, deeply connected to me. Embrace the vine and don't let go. And my life will flow into yours. My love will be yours to know and to share and to give away. Be a part of me as a branch is part of the vine. And God will produce marvelous fruit through your lives in every act of love that you're willing to give away. And then Jesus wants us to know what makes him the most joyful. You know what it is? What could fill your lives with joy instead of everything else that our lives are filled with? He commanded us, love each other the way I love you. That's what brings joy to the heart of God, for us to love each other the way he loves us. But why does he need to command us when you're already so eager to do that? Because often we don't. We get hard and selfish and hurt and angry. We get lazy and fearful and weak and weary. We let our old sins into the places that are supposed to be new life, and we get lost so easily. But when we seek to obey that command, the joy begins to flow again. Our hearts begin to beat with love again, and we find within us all the grace and forgiveness, all the patience and hope, all the trust and the faith that we need and we need to give away. It's the love you will need for your life together, as we read from 1 Corinthians 13. It's the love that never gives up, cares more for others than itself, doesn't force its own way, but puts up with anything, trusts God in everything, and always looks for the best in everything and in everyone. Embrace this love of Christ every day as you embrace each other. Hold it in your hearts as you hold on to each other, and you will have all the faith and hope and love you will need for your life together, all the grace and forgiveness you will need for every pain, all the strength and the hope for every problem you will face, and all the wisdom and patience for every difficulty in front of you. And then you will find that deep down joy that will draw you together no matter what, as lovers and friends that Christ has called you to be. Jesus said, greater love has no one than this, but that you lay down your life for your friends. God has given you a new life together to share. Lay it down in love for each other every day, and joy and hope will rise up within you. Lay down your lives for God's people, for Christ's purpose, for we need that love so much, and your life together will shine like the miracle that you are. Stephen, I have loved you since you were a boy, and now you are a grown man, a good man, and a strong man, with a beautiful heart. And Floor, I have to tell you that we loved you long before we met you, because you love this man that we love so much. But now to finally meet you and begin to know you, I know what Stephen meant when he told me, Pastor Chris, she is the best person I know. And that's saying something, because he knows some good people. You are a lovely woman with an even more beautiful heart. Your strong and joyful soul, your wisdom and graciousness, your tender and loving heart are so evident to all of us, and we are so thrilled that you two are best friends. But you will need more than that to be husband and wife, and today I promise that you will have it. Jesus said, no longer do I call you servants, but I call you my friends, if you do what I command you and love each other. It is with the ever-faithful friendship of God that you begin your life together. Hold on to it as you hold on to each other, and you will have a life filled with God's love and your joy. And if you choose to have children, we know that they will be the beautiful products of your marvelous hearts. And they, like you, will be miracles of light and love that our world so desperately needs to see. Stephen and Floor, in a few moments, you will be husband and wife. In the eyes of God, for our world and in our hearts, with love and thankfulness for you, we offer you our friendship for your life together and promise to pray for you and to do everything that God makes us able to do to bless you and your life together. But I have one more blessing to offer you. Floor, this comes from Stephen's grandparents, who could not be more thrilled but that you are together. Our blessing for Stephen and Floor. Although it is with sadness we cannot physically be with you today, know that our hearts and love are always with you wherever you go. Our prayer for you is both to always live, walk in God's light, and to let him guide you. He will never fail you. May you be blessed with many years together. And when the going gets rough, the tough get going. Own it. You're never alone throughout Savior Jesus Christ. He will always be with you. We love you both more than life itself, Grammy and Grampy. We love you too, and we thank God for you, and our hearts rejoice for your life together. In Jesus' name, amen. Sharon is now going to sing something beautiful for us.
Two hearts can come together and love can last forever. But now that I have found you, I believe that a miracle has come when God finds the perfect one. Now gone are all my questions about why, and I've never been so sure of anything in my life. Oh, I wonder what God was thinking when he created you. I wonder if he knew everything I would need, because he made all my dreams come true. When God made you, he must have been thinking about me. I promise you, wherever you may go, wherever life may lead you, with all my heart I'll be there too. And from this moment on, I want you to know I'll let nothing come between us, and I will be the ones you love. Now gone are all my questions about why, and I've never been so sure of anything in my life. Oh, I wonder what God was thinking when he created you. I wonder if he knew everything I would need, because he made all my dreams come true. When God made you, he must have been thinking about me. He made the moon to hum in perfect tune. One can't move without the other, they just have to be together. And that is why I know it's true. You're for me and I'm for you, 'cause my world just can't be right without about you in my life. I wonder what God was thinking when he created you. I wonder if he knew everything I would need, because he made all my dreams come true. He must have heard every prayer I've been praying, 'cause he knew everything I would need. Have been thinking about me.
And Steve, you are about to make the most important vows, the most sacred vows any human beings can make to one another. You know in your heart of hearts that this is what you want. Do you do this without reservation, without hesitation? Do you wholeheartedly pledge your life to each other? Are you ready to do this? Say yes?
Yes.
Yes, okay. Then it's time to get married. I'm going to ask your parents for a blessing. The parents of this man and woman, please rise. And Fredo, her brother. Will you, the parents of this man and woman, give your blessing to this marriage and promise to do everything, as God makes you able, that you can do to support them in their married life together, to love them and cherish them and let them be free and love them well? If so, please answer, we will. Thank you. Please be seated. Good people, you are God's witnesses in the world and in his kingdom of the rite of marriage, the vows between Floor and Stephen. You turn to each other. And you repeat after me. I, Stephen, take you, Floor, to be my wife.
I, Stephen, take you, Floor, to be my wife.
And I do promise and covenant. Before God and these witnesses, to be your loving and faithful husband, in plenty and in want, in joy and in sorrow, in sickness and in health, as long as we both shall live. Okay, Floor. I, Floor, take you, Stephen, to be my husband, and I do promise and covenant. Before God and these witnesses, to be your loving and faithful wife, in plenty and in want, in joy and in sorrow, in sickness and in health, as long as we both shall live. Wonderful. Stephen and Floor will now exchange wedding rings as the sign of the unending covenant of love between them and the God who gives it. Would you bow with me in prayer? Bless, O Lord, this ring, that he who gives it and she who wears it may abide in your peace and continue in your favor until their life's end. Amen. Floor, I love you. And I give you this ring as a sign of my love and faithfulness. Bow with me again. Bless, O Lord, this ring, that she who gives it and he who wears it may abide in your peace and continue in your favor until their life's end. Amen. Stephen, I love you, and I give you this ring as a sign of my love and faithfulness. Okay, join both hands, please. Good people, hear this good news. By the power given me as a minister of the Church of Jesus Christ, I now pronounce that Stephen and Floor are husband and wife, according to the ordinance of God and the laws of this state, and in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. What God has joined together, let no one put asunder. You may kiss. Receive this blessing. May the Lord God, who blessed our first parents and established them in marriage, so bless and establish you in marriage for the joy of your life together. Amen. Pastor Nestor will now lead us in the sand ceremony.
It is indeed a blessing and honor to be invited in this sacred moment for Stephen and Floor. Turn around and face your family and friends. Floor and Stephen have committed to share the rest of their life with each other. Tonight, this commitment will be symbolized in a sand ceremony through the pouring of two individual containers of sand, one representing Floor and all that she was, all that she is, and all that she will ever be. And the other representing Stephen and all that he was, all that he is, and all that he will ever be. To symbolize the importance of each of them within the marriage and the joining of their lives into one marriage, three colors of sand are combined. I will pour sand into the vase. It's a white sand, which symbolizes the love of God as foundation of the relationship. And all of us, biological family, church family, friends, supporting them in the marriage and holding them in love. Then Stephen and Floor will alternately pour their sand into the vase, symbolizing who they are as individuals. Then they will pour together, blending their two colors as a symbol of their joining together forever in love. So you can turn around and face me. Floor and Stephen, love is a force stronger than any other. It cannot be seen or measured, yet it is powerful enough to transform you in a moment and offer you more joy than any material possession ever could. But although this love joins you together as one, remember the gift of your individuality. Each of you comes to this relationship with unique strengths and weaknesses. As individuals, you are beautiful people, all on your own. Yet when the two of you are blended together, you form something even more beautiful. Those strengths can blossom, and those weaknesses can be cared for. So may God bless this marriage so that you are inseparable as these grains of sand. In Jesus' name, amen.
I can only imagine what it will be like when I walk by your side. I can only imagine what my eyes will see when your face is before me. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you?
So for everyone, please hold somebody's hand and let's pray. Hand in hand we come before you, O God. Hand in hand we come stepping out in faith. We who are gathered here ask that you would take this couple into your hands. Help them, O Lord, to keep firm in the commitments they have just made. Guide them, gracious God, as they become a family, as they each change through the years. May they be flexible as they are faithful. Let their love for each other be a seal upon their hearts, a mantle about their shoulders, and a crown upon their foreheads. Oh, bless them in their work and in their companionship, in their sleeping and in their waking, in their joys and in their sorrows. And God of love, help us all to be your hands if there be need. Strengthen tenderly all of our commitments. And we pray this through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen.
It's done. And we beat the horn by another minute. You're about to begin your new life together, and I offer you the best thing I can. It is the blessing of God. And my love, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord will make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon you and grant you his peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. It is my great joy to introduce to you as husband and wife, Mr. and Mrs. Stephen Cole.